Welcome to Maximum Battle. I'm here in Prince's Hall, Aldershot. It's Sunday, the 22nd of January. I'm with the lovely Ring Girls. Say hello.
Hi.
We've got an action-packed night for you tonight. We've already had three amazing fights. I think the fourth one's just finished. We had Sam Horsfall, who done really well against a late opponent as his opponent pulled out. Coming up, we've got obviously Dapper fighting. We've also got Aaron Collins, who's fighting, who is defending his title against Zabi Sahabi. So they're two great fighters, both very in their prime, young, both unbeaten records. So first of all, without further ado, let me introduce you to Huckle, who is going to be Dapper's opponent. Yay! Hello, Huckle. How are we doing?
Yeah, good, mate.
So, Huckle, how are you feeling?
Feeling good, thanks.
Good. So you took this fight a little late notice and you've been training hard. I've seen you every day. So how's the training been going?
It's been a lot different to what I'm usually up to, but I'm feeling all right, feeling good to be fair, looking cool. To just get in there now.
The great thing with Huckle is that obviously he's a lad just like Dapper, so they enjoy the best sides of life. But when we spoke, when I originally approached you, Huckle, just tell us what and why you actually did want to do it.
Well, last year I was diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. And I beat that end of last year, and my mum passed away last year as well. So, just want to do something, give back a little bit. Yeah.
Yeah.
Other than going out.
So when I actually spoke to Huckle, he was just saying to me that the Macmillan Foundation, they really helped you with the money and stuff, and that's what we're doing tonight. We're collecting in the venue for everyone, and we're doing it for Huckle. So it's a real worthy cause. It's the same as Dapper. They're doing it for charity. It's such an amazing thing. And, you know, not many people get hit to raise money for other people. And just on the charity front, we've already hit the first target. We're hoping to raise £20,000 in total. So we've already raised 5,000 from ticket sales, and we're on about $6,000-$7,000, girls.
Yeah.
6,400 for the Just Giving page. All we're asking you to do is just donate a small amount, just to say your appreciation for Huckle potentially knocking out or getting knocked out against Dapple. Yeah? So just please go to the Just Giving page with, what are we on? 21,000 viewers. If those 21,000 viewers just donated £1 each, we'd hit our target easily. So to help, please click share, which is on the bottom corner, not sure which side. And also, if we get enough viewers, we might get our ring girls to do something for you. So please hit share and please donate, just as a nice thank you for, you know, Dapper getting hit. Yeah. So good luck for tonight, Huckle. I know you've got to go and warm up. Thank you very much. So whilst we got him, we've got Matt Gorton here, who's been training Huckle. So Matt, if you want to come in. How you doing, Matt? You good? Yeah, sorry, Dapper. So sorry, this is Dapper's trainer. So just tell us a little bit about what they go through, what they do, how hard it is and that.
Well, Dapper, Dan.
Take over, mate.
Dapper, Dan. Yeah. Right, excuse me, mate. So, do you want some water?
Yeah,
can someone give him some water? Happy now?
Yeah, sorry, boss.
Dan came in the gym about 3 months ago with a great idea and quite an honourable idea of raising money for Help for Heroes. So he's had a busy 3 months, as anyone that knows him. He's been doing a film, his wife's given a baby, and, you know, anyone that knows that, anyone that knows that is enough of a commitment, but he's carried on with a box, and he could have easily said, oh, I'm going to jack it and I'm not going to do this, but he's been turning up, he's been training, sort of been doing a diet.
Yeah.
50%. But all joking aside, he's committed himself to it, and he's up for it tonight, you know, and the lad, the gentleman he's fighting, Huckle's got a lot of reasons to box as well. So it's a good show, and more importantly, fair play to both of them. You know, they're both putting on the line. They don't have to do it. It takes a lot of balls to walk into a ring, you know, in front of all that crowd. So, you know, massive take matters to both the lads. I really do.
Cool. Just 1 second. Can someone go and get Dapper for us so we can have a chat with him, if that's all right, guys? And so just while you're there. So, Matt, obviously, it's a lot for them to do, and it's a lot of commitment, and they do it. You used to fight when you was younger. What kind of things do you remember your first fight?
Yeah, I do remember my first fight, and there'll be people on here laughing away at it because it was like windmills galore.
Yeah.
But I mean, the biggest thing with your first fight is trying to control your nerves, you know, especially in front of people. It's all very well doing the rounds in the ring when it's you're training, maybe a couple of sparring partners. But when you step up in front of those people, it's like, someone rips your back out, takes the batteries out and sews you back up and shoves you out there. So the big question will be if both the lads can control that adrenaline dump. Might suit Dapper, he's always in front of a crowd, so we'll see.
Well, this was my fear, is that I've seen Dapper, he's been watching the shows and he's been getting a little bit excited already. Yeah. And I'm trying to tell him, calm down. Yeah. Huckle's got quite a few friends and family here, so he's excited as well. And many a time these fighters, they'll come out, they've used up all their adrenaline and nervous energy.
Yeah.
But, you know, I mean, it's such a big platform for them to do it on.
Yeah.
Cool. So, how's the show been so far? How have you done with Sam Horse, who had a good fight here?
Yeah, Sam fought a real tough journeyman and won it over 3 rounds. I was well pleased. Young Brandon Ayres, we've been doing a lot of work in the gym with him. And he won his fight as well. So we're looking forward to the rest of the night, really. We've got another 2 on plus Dapper, so it's all going really good. Standard maximum battle, good, hard, competitive bouts and a massive, good, really good atmosphere.
Cool. Thank you very much, Matt. I'll let you get back to you guys, Matt. Appreciate it. So, please remember, we've just got a fight going through now. So please remember to click share and please remember to donate. It's all for charity. It's all for Help the Heroes. We're doing it in aid of Boxing for Heroes. And Huckle, he's got a Just Giving page as well. We'd love you to donate to that. So upcoming, we've got a fight. We're just going to step out of the way a second. If you just move to one side, cameraman. Sorry. Oh, they've gone round the other way. Cool. Right, we've just got some guys. So this is what we call a green room. This is where they get the people in and they get them ready. So if I just get the camera to show you. Oh, here's Dapper now. How are we doing, Dapper? If you just, oh, we got Chris Eubank Jr. as well. How are we doing, sir? You good? Cool. Dapper, you good? Cool, right.
So we live on my Facebook?
We're live on your Facebook. We've got 3 viewers.
How many are watching? 25,000. We've got 25, fuck, that's more views than I've ever had.
26,400.
Oh, it's just gone up when I said fuck. What's going on? We've got, Chris has come down to support us. Thank you.
Let me ask a couple of things anyway. So, nice for you to come here, Chris. We appreciate you coming to for the fight. Also, obviously, you're obviously respectful for Dapper because he went easy. You've got an upcoming fight as well on you.
I didn't want to get worn out before my first world title fight, February 4th. So, he did me a favour on that one.
I see him work the ribs.
No, I'll tell you what, I've never been so knackered trying to hit someone in my whole life. I couldn't touch him. But do you know what? His fight is not very long away, is it? How long we got?
2 weeks away now, yeah. February 4th, fighting for IBO Super Middleweight World title. So we're on track.
So this is your first big world title. It's going to be a great occasion, I believe.
Yeah, well, this is what I've been working for my entire career. And he knows how hard it is, the graft you've got to put in, the dedication.
Eight weeks I've done it.
He's done 8 weeks, and he's feeling it.
I've lost 2 pounds.
An hour a day isn't the same as 8 hours a day.
So
how are you feeling about your fight in that?
I feel good, but before we crack on, I just want to say thanks to Chris, mate, because I know that you're the same as me. You're like Marmite. People either love you or hate you. Do you know what I mean? He's the same as me. That's why I think that we've connected. A lot of people won't know this. He come down and watched me do stand up like about two, three. I didn't even know this about 3 years ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, in Brighton.
And so it's not like we're just jumping on each other's bandwagons. You know, we've had this synergy for a little while now, and he's come down 2 weeks before the fight to support Help the Heroes. So big up yourself.
So, Dan, if you remember back to when we first met and the half.
Do us a favour, click share. Sharing is caring. Ask your mum. Sorry. She knows.
Yeah. Click love as well, because he loves your mum.
Yeah.
See, I can do him too.
What, mums?
Yeah.
Okay.
So back when I met you for the first time, you looked like a wreck and you wanted to train and you wanted to do it for charity. Just take us through that, when we first met, how you was feeling, what you wanted to do.
Well, I remember actually watching your Snapchats thinking, that'd be all right, I'll get involved. I'll get involved and I'll do it.
Everyone thinks that. They watch people who are training and they think, it's easy, it's nothing. Once you actually get involved stay out is. It's a different world.
I'll tell you what, after the first hour, I remember, after the first hour, he said to me, like, are you sure you want to do this? And I was like, but you know what? I'd had a taste of it. And I was like, I want to do it. And I went balls deep in the promotion of it before I even had the first training session. So I was like, I ain't got a choice now. But you know what? I found it difficult because I put on a lot of weight when my old man passed away, boozing and stuff, right?
Yeah.
As you know. That was a bit difficult. It's been difficult to lose weight, but I tell you what, I've really got into the boxing and I really feel confident.
Yeah, you've actually naturally taken to it, and you do love it. Otherwise, you wouldn't do it. That's the main thing. Obviously, you've been training hard. What's the camp that you're in, like Maximus? How are you finding that? How are you finding the guys?
They're proper camp. Sorry.
I'll get one out here now.
They're all right. They're brutal. They don't mess around. Quite similar to when I come down to watch you spar. Not nowhere near like that sparring, but similar type of gym that I saw you in, like rough and ready, and yeah.
You've got to live the life, and you've got to be in with people that, you know, want to get involved. You know, I go to a lot of these gyms, and you've got guys that kind of just hitting the bag, tip tapping, talking on the phones. You're not gonna get yourself ready for a fight that way. So obviously he's around the right people.
Get rid of that phone.
No, you're right. Yeah. Well, I know Maximus is spit and sawdust, but they've obviously run out of sawdust. It's just spit.
Oh, by the way, I just want to say I love, it's not, do you like it, girls, is it?
I do.
Yeah.
There we go, there's one vote.
Where did you get this, right?
Wait, this is what I say, every time I look for clothes, it always comes up with novelty or joke item.
Yeah, it looks good. I mean, guys, if you're watching this, we've managed to raise... fucking over 10 grand now.
Yeah, well over 10 grand. What, without you saying, I want to raise 20 grand tonight. I think, look, we've got, how many viewers we got at the moment, Richie?
We're on £6,525, and we've got 40,000.
Right, there's 40,000 people watching now. If half of you click share, then loads of people, that will jump up. But listen, with that many people watching, the link is on there. If after this, after you watch me getting punched for charity, if you go on there and stick a quid on it, it'll make a massive difference. I sound like I'm on fucking, was it Children for Need? No, what is it?
Children in Need.
Children for Need.
You're the one in need.
Anyway, should we get Chris off here before I say something stupid? Pleasure, Chris.
Chris, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Enjoy the show. Just so you know, we've got a real good fight. We've got Aaron Collins. Chris, we've got Aaron Collins versus Zabi Chahabi. It's one to watch. He's up and coming. One day, we hope for.
We best get him off the camera before I say something. You know what I'm like, I'll end up back on fucking Newsnight with me turtleneck on. Right. Oh, you all right?
I'm good, I'm getting nervous.
37,000 people watching.
Cool. So we got one fight. The plan is we're going to watch the title fight, and then we're going to chat with some of your friends and family and some of the celebrities. Don't get distracted.
Sorry.
Yeah. Dan, we've got loads of your friends here, loads of your family here. We've got 100 of your fans here. What's it like? What's it feel like to have all those people here? What does the support mean to you?
I'll be completely honest with y'all, and a lot of people won't know this. Alex Huckle, the gentleman that's doing this, a couple of years ago, I think it was, he beat cancer himself, and he's raising money for cancer. So the honest truth is, everyone's been licking my arse saying to me, it's a noble thing what you're doing. You've got to have minerals to get in the ring. I'll tell you something now. I've got a lot of support here and probably a lot of people watching online, obviously, a lot of people behind me. It is twice as hard what he's doing tonight than what I'm doing. So I'm not licking his ass, but I've got to put my hands up and say I appreciate. I've got my mum out there.
Yep, I've already met her.
Have you?
Yeah, lovely girl. Yeah. Tight ass.
All right. Oh, I can't even say she knows now. No, yeah, leave my mum out of it. She has got nice boobs though. I should know. I sucked them. Anyway. Seriously, my mum's there, so if it kicks off bad, she's got a bottle of Lambrini in front of her. Well,
I know it's an empty bottle now, trust me.
Oh, she's smashed already. I feel blessed that I've got a lot of people here supporting me. I just, you know, click share, put some money in, and thank you for everyone that's supported it so far.
Just
10 grand off my race for this, I'm loving it.
Well, yesterday we had the weigh-ins, which was for the first time you kind of come face-to-face with Huckle, and I remember you saying to me, like, a weight had been lifted off your shoulders when you come in. You said, that's Huckle out there. He was just eating a bag of M&Ms before the weigh-in.
I walked into the weigh-in, and I walked past him, and we give each other a stare like that. I looked at him, and I was like, yeah, like, you want to go? And he looked at me. As he looked at me, he pulled out a pack of M&Ms. I opened them and started having M&Ms. I thought, I fucking got this.
So how was it yesterday? It was the first part of the build-up. This is when shit is getting real.
Yeah. I mean, you can hear it now. The worst thing that I've done, he said to me, come up and watch some of the fights, some of the other lads that we've got fighting.
I said, don't.
Yeah, okay. Well, some of the other lads said, come and watch them. I come and watch them, and it is fucking brutal. You're going to see a great fighter fighting in a minute, Aaron, that actually done me in the ribs and put me down in sparring. But I watched them, and it's brutal. The hype is a little bit fucking scary.
Yeah, listen, the atmosphere, you, for some reason, look, I watch the DVDs back when we do these fights, and you can't just feel the atmosphere that you do here. It's electrifying. Everyone's pissed up. Everyone's screaming their heads off. They are just shouting for the cause. And the great thing is, especially with yours, your thing, I've been seeing on Facebook now, most of the people are loving it. They're just, yeah. they're embracing it. It's not, there's no hatred. It's just for a good cause. Yeah. It's just for... People are seeing it.
I mean, this is the biggest live feed that I've ever had on my Facebook. Like 31,000 people watching now, and we're up to £6,000. This is the most amount of people watching, and I think that's because normally I've got half of that, people that like me. I think the other half are people that are watching, waiting for me to get knocked out, to be fair. But it's
I'm thinking the other half are for me, but...
Oh, yeah, well, yeah. But, God, he's quite good at this. Yeah, but you know what? Win or lose, or draw, or whatever, I'm happy that we smashed the 10 grand mark, but fuck it. But fuck it. People taking the piss out of his jacket, but I'll put it this way, I want to fucking win, so I'm going to have it.
Good. Come on, put your comments on that. If you're going to comment, you've got to donate as well. Do you want to have a little read of it?
Let's have a little look.
Yeah.
God, fuck me, I look fat.
Yeah, I look good. So, Dapper, you've been training for a few weeks. Now, the reality is, you come with great intentions, but listen, real life caught up with you. You filmed for 3 weeks, your film fanged up.
Yeah.
You also had a baby.
Yeah.
You also had Christmas.
Yeah.
Could you put anything more in there to disrupt your training?
Well, we had 8 weeks training, and Matt, my trainer, really fucking put me through it hardcore. And especially the last 2 weeks, he's been sparring with me at a level that, well, you saw, yeah, I've been getting proper knocked about. Hold on a second, I've got to pause it. Come over here.
Come
on,
man.
Good. All right. We've got 35,000. We got 35,000 people watching the live stream.
Is that it? Now that I've turned on, it's going to go right up.
So
at least 50,000.
So for those of you that don't recognise his face, because he ain't that boaty. Oh, got a couple of sweethearts over there. Hiya.
No, they're probably with me.
Are they with you?
No, that's Aaron's wife.
That's Aaron's wife.
That's
right, Aaron's wife. Who's fighting next?
Sorry, Aaron. Not wrong person.
Sorry, sweetheart. awkward. You do want to borrow me turtleneck?
Yeah.
This is Jason Mazza from Brotherhood, the film Brotherhood.
Thank you.
But also, probably that got more exposure for him from my Snapchats in Ibiza.
That is also true, yes. Unfortunately, yes.
Now, normally my other partner in crime, Nick Nevin, our partner in crime,
yes.
It's a wild one in a man. I mean, he's not here because he's, where is he? He's in Nice.
Apparently he's filming something.
Yeah.
Yeah. No excuse, to be honest, I think. So, yeah. Are you so relaxed? This is unbelievable.
I've done a fat line of coke before.
Yeah. Are we getting the drug testers in here?
I am the drug tester. I've just done the whole lot over there.
I've never seen this, but he's actually got pecs, the boy. He's actually got pecs. He looks brilliant.
Yeah. For those of you that are watching, we're up to 37,000 people watching.
I told you it was going to rise up when I... And then this good looking man's here as well, so...
I'm going to introduce this fellow in a sec, but by the way, guys, little thing for you. See these shorts? I'm already sweating in these shorts, right? You can smell the gooch coming from the middle, right? And I'm going to be giving... See? He knows. but listen, the truth is we're going to get these signed by loads of people. And everyone that clicks share now, that shares it, we're going to give them away to someone that shares it. You got any tips for me in the ring?
Yeah, I feel like, listen... You got to go in there. You got to be relaxed for the first round. Just relax it. Find yourself, and if that all goes Pete's song, win million in is what I'm recommending.
Okay. Keys out.
No. Seriously, relax in the first round, because the problem is most of them lot in there, they just want to go for it the first round. Try and find the range. Relax it. Take some deep breaths, and then just work your game. I've seen you in training. You actually, I have to say, it can actually look like you can actually throw a punch. Yeah. So you know you got it in there. Just don't wear yourself out, because some of them are absolutely shattered after the first round, and then they've got nothing left. So,
worst case scenario, I'm going to fucking nut someone.
I think that also, you know, it get the crowd. And also, listen, the other thing is that you are a natural entertainer. I've just spoken to Kevin Mitchell up there, yeah? Kevin said he's going to be all right.
They're screaming for you.
And he said, look, he's going to be all right because he's an entertainer. So I want to see some of them Ali shuffles, you know what I mean? That's what I'm expecting.
All right, wicked. 38,000 we're up to now. Click share. How are we doing? We're all right for time?
Yeah.
Go on.
You need to go and get ready. You need to compose yourself. You need to get. Yep.
This just quickly. This is. Are we at 7,000? We got on the donations. Oh, we're going up on the donations as well. You might have, you probably won't recognise this fella, but you will do soon. He's in my film Fanged Up. Mazza didn't pass the audition for that, unfortunately. No, no, we couldn't afford him. but anyway, Luke, I asked Luke to introduce me to someone to do this. Luke put it all, introduced me to Foxy, but I went to school with Luke, didn't I? Me and you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Tell him what I was like at school. Just say it. Yeah, go on.
Cunt.
Under 18, we apologise.
Yeah.
No, sorry about that. No. Take me out off. You are, but you're a top boy.
I don't know. That makes it. I don't know.
I love you.
It's like getting called a shitty shag by your girlfriend.
We're safe hands, like I said to you, and you know what I mean?
James, good man.
Matty, you know what I mean?
Good man. All right, 41,000 views. I'm gonna pass back. Look, I'm hogging. 41,000 views. Click share again. I'm going to be fighting soon. You two girls all right? Good stuff. Here you go.
Yeah, thanks. It's my show. Right. I'm just going to get Aaron Collins' lovely wife here to come and have a quick chat because Aaron's up next. Yep, you need to go and relax. Well done, Dapper. How are we doing, everyone? It's not long now until Dapper and Huckle's fight. I've managed to get one of Huckle's friends, Ben Bryant. So, Ben, how's Huckle been doing? How's he been feeling?
Yeah, he's good. He's training hard. He's working hard. It's obviously, you know what I mean, it's a tough thing to get in there and do that, especially when you've never done it before. So
when we were speaking to him, because Ben was there when I was speaking to Alex, he was really up for it and he just needed a little push over the edge. He wanted to do it for charity. And if you remember, what did... You, well, I think it was you promised him.
I think that from the back of this, he's probably going to get laid, and which hasn't happened for a while. So I think that this is probably his main goal, his main priority is this, is he might get laid afterwards. And to be fair, he's probably had a few ads and a few few likes from what he's doing. So yeah, get laid.
So girls, if you want, add up Huckle. He's Swagger Huckle on Snapchat. Drop him a snap, wish him some luck. Tell him you're a big fan and a dad bod. And show him love. So what's your prediction, Huckle and Dapper?
Huckle, second round knockout. That's what we're going for.
Good luck. No, I can't call it. Right, thank you very much, Ben. Cool. Right, we're near about 10, 15 minutes away from the fight. We're just going to go and have a few chats with some celebrities. I'm just going to have a quick say hello to some of the ring girls. So this is Lydia. Say hello, Lydia.
Hi. Hi, everybody. Hi.
Say hello.
Hello.
So if you like this, make sure you hit share, make sure you hit donate, make sure we try and build up the audience. What we want to do is get everyone there. We want to get them to donate. So come with me, let's go and chat with some celebs. Sorry.
I really want to get back into it.
Yeah. Oh, me? Okay, I'm just going to the loo.
No, you have to wait. Right, we're doing it now. Right. Check one, can you hear me all right?
Hold the mic very close.
Yes. Okay.
Should we get out of the way?
No, that's it. Right. Can you hear me okay? Yeah, okay. Hi. I'm here with one of Dan, who is Dapper's cousin. So just tell us a bit about growing up with Dan and what's he like?
What's he like? A nutter. He's always been a bit of a nutter. He used to throw darts at me when I was a kid. But as you'll learn tonight, he hasn't got kind of the best accuracy. So I was fine. I dodged it. Yeah, always a bit of a ladies' man. I remember when I was a kid, he came to one of my like school dances, stole the show with the worm. First time anyone had seen the worm. So he's just an attention seeker, basically. Hence tonight. So yeah.
So he's doing it for a good cause. We're up to 7,200. What do you think about the cause and that, and what he's doing it for?
Yeah, it's really nice to see him effectively do something for someone else, rather than to further his own career or his own self-interest. So that's a nice change of pace for him.
Have you been watching his training and how he's been getting on?
Yeah, I've been. I mean, it looks like an extremely like intensive and extensive training regime. But all credit to him, he's managed to maintain that kind of doughy, blubbery frame, which I think is great because you know he can absorb the body shots. So fair play to him. He's gonna
be like a jelly.
to be honest, I think it's all for Snapchat anyway. It's like 5 seconds of this and then he's off down the pub again. So
yeah, he's puffing out, he gets his breath back, then he goes down the pub. Anyway, thanks for chatting to us. We're gonna go and chat to a few more. Follow me. We'll have a quick chat, Mazza.
Yes, let's
do it. So this is Dapper's best friend, Mazza. We had a quick chat with him earlier. How are you feeling about him for him, honestly? Are you nervous?
I am concerned. But look, as long as he doesn't embarrass himself, because if he embarrasses himself, he embarrasses me. So that's the main thing. So I'm hoping that he doesn't embarrass. No, but listen, he's put the train in him. I mean, a lot of people have been saying, actually, he looks heavier now than when he started. That also concerns me. I'm worried what's going on here.
He did actually weigh in about 130 grams lighter.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so proud of him. That's a beautiful thing. So it's a muscle, clearly. It's all right. It's good. It's good. Yeah.
I think it was just one big shit. That's the only difference.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, just before he went on. Yeah. No, it's going to be good.
Yeah. So did you... You obviously heard he worked up on Fanged Up, so how do you feel about him getting into the film industry, your industry?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, being an actor myself, I've got competition now.
Yeah.
And now I just hope the friendship is in effect, you know. And also, can we just say, I'm not in his own movie. We are very, very good pals, very, very close, and he didn't put me in the... Oh, it's kicking off. It's all part of the atmosphere.
One second. Right, if we just come over it...
Calm down.
We've obviously got Huckle versus Dapper coming up. What's your feelings on the match or on the fight? What do you think?
I just think that, listen, when you're in boxing, it's very, you can never know where it's going to go. Boxing's boxing.
Yeah.
I'm hoping Dapper does really well. He shines bright. It's an hard game, you know. We'll just see how it goes. It's hard. It's his first time in the ring. And we'll see how he takes his approach to it and see how he deals with it.
Yeah, listen, the great thing is it's such a fair match. They're both equally unfit. They're both equally undertrained. So we have a saying in a fight game, you only need two donkeys to make a race. And I think it's going to be some race.
I had a chat with his mate earlier. I mean, Kev, he's put on more weight since he's been training, Dapper. Yeah. I started laughing. I said, my best mate just said the exact same thing. Looks like he's put on my weight. So we'll just see how it goes. It's boxing, like, to be fair, it's very brave for the pair of them to get in there. And it's a great call, so it's perfect. It's maybe a bit good night, I think.
Yeah, definitely. They're doing it for the right reasons. Yeah. We just had a chat with one of Huckle's friends down there. He's obviously doing it to get laid as well, hopefully.
They all want to get laid, don't they?
And a bit famous, and I've been obviously with Dan going through the motions and that, and he's been messaging me a lot about things, and I think it is affecting him obviously, and he is getting the nerves about it.
Naturally he'll get the nerves, naturally he'll be scared. I had like 44 pro fights, so I had 50 amateur fights. Every fight I fought, I was always scared. Naturally, you're naturally going to be scared. Me and Big Joe, speaking about Joe, you naturally get scared, Joe, didn't you? You're naturally always fearful. Your first fight, your last fight, he'd always be scared. It's how he deals with his nerves. I believe he's a showman. So when you're in the ring in front of a crowd, you have to be a showman. Some people get very scared with it. I was a very nervous person in front of crowds. I got very nervous. But I believe Dapper, he is a great showman. He's one of the best showmen. So we'll see how he deals with it.
Yeah, that's the great thing with him. He will have the confidence in there. But on the flip side, like I was saying earlier, he's like bopping around, he's all excited, he wants to do it. And as you know, if you use up all that adrenaline, that nervous energy, you're going to start throwing a few windmills.
The windmills, definitely. That foul, his first fight, his windmills naturally be thrown. Yeah. His pride will come into it. He will think about his family, he will think about his close friends, his friends here, to less than me. He will think about them all, and naturally, he'll go all guns blazing.
Yeah.
It's how he deals with the hype. It's destroyed him and took the energy out of him, it'd be his downfall. But if he embraces it and enjoys it, it'd be good to him, yeah.
Yeah, I think with a big crowd behind him, I just wait a minute. The big crowd behind him, I think that's going to push him through, you know, with everyone shouting, screaming. And the great thing up here, we've got such a close ringside action that they almost can touch him. If there's a little bit of blood spilt, you're going to get it on your jumper.
I'm sitting very close. And fingers crossed, he is a showman. I think he'll live up to his height. I think he'll do his thing. I think he'll be victorious. Cool.
Well, thanks for chatting to us.
Thank you very much.
Cool. Right, let's go and find some other people. Dapper's mum's here somewhere, so I just want to find out what's life like with Dapper as a kid. Where is she?
Ladies and gentlemen of the Princess Hall and all the shop, hello!
for joining us here tonight at the Prince's Hall in Aldershot. I've just heard we've got a record 40,000 viewers watching us live here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for the main event of the evening. So please welcome into the blue corner from Maximus Gym, Alex Hooker.
Thank you.
seconds out. Round two. Yeah. After three fantastic rounds of boxing action, the judges have reached a majority decision. The bouts were scored. Round one, 10-10. Round two, 10-9. Round three, 10-9. All in favour of your winner. In the red corner, Devon! Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it from...